The 1989 Topps baseball card set offered up a few things to distinguish it from its competitors. First, as always, Topps treated collectors to mushy brown cardstock rather than the upgraded white stuff that other manufacturers were using by that point. Next, we knew out of the gate that Topps would be as common as dirt. With other sets, there was some hope for scarcity, but we knew where we stood with Topps. Maybe most significantly, Topps was the only company, except for Score, not to include a rookie card of Ken Griffey Jr. in their set. No matter how much advance press Jr. got, it seemed he would have to wait for Topps Traded to make his debut with the old gum company. Now, I realize those distinctions sound negative for Topps, but they did do some things right. For one thing, the 1989 Topps design was pretty solid. Nothing earth-shattering, but a clean, simple layout that kind of hinted at 1965 Topps in a whispering sort of way. The pinkish card backs were distinctive too, and definitely had the Toppsy feeling we all know and love. And while they missed out on Griffey, Topps did manage to nab pretty solid rookies for their 1989 base set. Among those first-year players who generated excitement either in 1989 or later on were Bill Benet, Daryl Hamilton, Monty Ferris, Raymond Martinez, Rob Dibble, Jack Armstrong, Gary Sheffield, Ricky Jordan, Andy Benes, Chris Sabo, Jim Abbott, Willie Ansley, Randy Johnson, Brady Anderson, Dante Bichette, Robin Ventura, and Steve Avery. That's a solid bunch of players, regardless of how many of each card Topps produced. Some of them shone early in their careers, some late, and some pretty much all the way through. You might even recognize a couple of award winners among the group, as well as one oversized Hall of Famer. To that list, you can also add Greg Jeffries, who wasn't a rookie but made his base set Topps debut with a Future Star card. That's a really solid pasteboard and something of an icon for a set that never gained a huge collector following, but there is at least one card that's even better overall. That card would be number 648, a Sandy Alomar Jr. Like the Jeffries and Sheffield cards, the Alomar rookie is dubbed a Future Star. And unlike the Jeffries, the Alomar rookie card is just that, a rookie card. That's it. It's Alomar's first base Topps issue, and it's a really nifty one. There is a young Sandy in his chocolate San Diego Padres uniform, with his catcher's mitt extended, ball just lodging itself in his palm. Alomar appears to be jawing with whoever just threw the horsehide, a slight smile on his face lending a light air to the whole scene. Overall, this card is a striking visual of a guy who would win the American League Rookie of the Year award with the Cleveland Indians in 1990, en route to a 20-year Major League career. Will Sandy Alomar ever pick up a Hall of Fame plaque? Nah, not as a player anyway, but he's already picked up the honor of appearing on the best 1989 Topps baseball card. Like our video? Then like our videos and subscribe to our channel. WaxPackGods.com